strike is symptomatic of a deep malaise, but let's try and understand the real reason behind the strike. And let me actually first try and assess the impact. Mr. Goyal, what is the kind of impact that this strike has had on the brand value of Air India, on passengers who are clearly stranded and absolutely upset with what has happened?
This is not the first time the pilots have gone on strike.
Right.
Whenever the peak season is there, whether it's the tourist season or the summer season, the pilots go on strike. I don't understand, on some pretext or the other, they are always on strike. Now, we are trying to introduce discipline by terminating the pilots. We will not have discipline because they will find jobs in private airlines who are wanting that Air India should die. What I said before, and I am repeating it now, that the pilots who go on strike, they are one of the highest paid pilots.
Right.
Their licenses should be cancelled because there is a court decision against them. Right. They are not bothered about the court. They are not bothered about the public. There are other people also working in Air India. There are the loaders. There are the ground staff. There is the cabin crew. All those people also have jobs. So, I mean, to just let the pilots, as rightly mentioned by Mr. Kohli, hold not only the airline and the public to ransom, but spoil the image of the entire country, because this is the condition of the national carrier. So if we do not take, if we do not suspend the licenses, I mean cancel the licenses of the pilots,
let me actually take
then that. Then I'm sorry, whatever you may do, they will again go on strike. So there is no point giving them bailout.
Okay, so do you need an even tougher stance?
Let me actually talk to govern, then let them shut down everything. I will say it is the same vested interest when Singapore Airlines was trying to invest in Air India and make it professional with the help of Tatas,
yes,
who were the founders of Air India. There was a vested interest, but didn't let it happen.
Yes, may I just complete what I was saying? As far as even privatization
yes,
is concerned,
go ahead.
As far as privatization is concerned also, if you remember, the pilots themselves had put in a bid to buy off Air India during the BJP time. We had met, I was on the committee myself also, and we had put up a whole project of how Air India can be privatized. We met Mr. Arun Shori, we had extensive discussions with him, and recently, a few months back, I met Arun Shori by accident at Lavasa, where he resides, and he told me, Captain, it would have been so wonderful if you had people had bought over the airline at that time. I said, you were the minister at that time, you didn't let it happen. So why blame someone else? There have been a lot of reasons. If there is an inquiry, there'll be a mountain of evidence that will come out. And if you do not take,
and there have been inquiries, perhaps, yeah. And are we shying away from fixing that responsibility? Yes, Mr. Goyal, go ahead before I take a break.
You see, firstly, the government must have the guts to take a decision. You see, the patient is dying on the table. We are going into the past, and we are saying some doctors are on strike, and some doctors are saying no, we'll operate the patient. You see, Air India is dying. Either we let it die, or we, you know, close it down and restart it, restructure it, and then restart it.
May I answer that question also? What you are raising?
We privatize it, but when the privatization was taking place, you see, it is the same people who are now, you know, behind the scenes encouraging the strikes. They were the ones who didn't allow Singapore Airline and Air India merger with the Tatas to take place. Now,
yes,
that is the vested interest which is killing the airline.
The government can't do anything
unless the government stops interfering and the consultant or whoever the CEO is given a free hand to restructure the airline.
But
you see, you put a man as a puppet and control the strings of that person, then there is no way the airline can be restructured.
If one or two
pilots' licenses had been cancelled who are disobeying the court orders, there has to be some discipline. Just because it will take more time, there are Air Force pilots that can be trained on commercial in a few months.
Is it that simple?
No, it isn't that simple. You have pilots in Air Force, all right.
But
But when you do the type rating for a particular aircraft, it is 10 crores of rupees. It's not that simple. And coming back to what Kapil responded to my earlier point, I would like to clarify, I was only urging the government to look from the point of economics of the airline.
We cannot allow
if you don't look
at pilots. You made your point, Mr. Goyal. Let's just listen to Mr. Bhargav very quickly.
The Mr. Wadia said that the guilty who have looted Air India should not be spared.
Alright,
whoever they are.
Time to start fixing responsibility, yes. And heads must roll.